After Charlie left, only two men have ever gone back. And there's good reason for that. The energy required to break free from Earth's gravitational embrace is staggering. This is the spacecraft that took John Young, Ken Mattingly and Charlie Duke to the moon. The service module and the command module, that's the engine that fired to bring them back from the moon to the Earth. The lunar lander sat inside there. And this piece is essentially a single rocket motor that fired to take them from Earth orbit to the moon. So this is the 120-ton moon spacecraft, if you like. But from a physics perspective, the difficulty is getting that into orbit. And on a Saturn V, that was done in two bits. And this is stage two. And that is the stage two fuel tank. Inside there are 450 tons of rocket fuel. And this burned through those 450 tons in about 6 minutes, taking the spacecraft from an altitude of 200,000 feet, 38 miles, up to 114.5 miles. That's virtually in orbit. And it did that by burning the fuel in five engines. Now, at the time, that was one of the most powerful rockets ever built, but not the most powerful. That was this, stage one. Saturn V. There are 2,200 tons of fuel in here, and stage one burnt through that in about 2.5 minutes. To do that, it had fuel pumps that were more powerful than a 747 at liftoff to pump 15 tons of fuel a second into these, the F1 engines. Every statistic about these engines is ridiculous. In those 2.5 minutes when this spacecraft was lifting off, the power generated was more than the peak electrical power generation capacity of the United Kingdom.